summer in Minnesota. Our state counts on a warm, dry weather season, so everybody from in the state and outside of it can get here and enjoy it, whether that's up north in the boundary waters or next door at Lake Minnetonka. But this most recent summer was rough across the board for the businesses that rely on people coming into our state to spend their money. Gordon's here to explain what happened.
Yeah, Explore Minnesota surveyed more than 250 small business owners to see how they did this summer. They heard from a lot of hotels, bars, and restaurants, and about half say business was down this year. Explore Minnesota says there are some big challenges owners are dealing with, but there are reasons to be optimistic for the future.
There's a saying in Minnesota that when things go wrong, you can blame it on the weather.
The weather this summer has been a huge factor.
Lauren Bennett McGinty from Explore Minnesota says there is some truth to that phrase this year. First, we had a mild winter, which hurt a lot of tourism cities that rely on winter recreation. And then came the rain this summer.
Of course, they're outdoor focused in the summertime, and because of all the days of rain, it was really challenging for them to have more people come and spend their time outdoors and experience all that they have to offer.
But you can't blame everything on the weather. In the survey, business owners say their three biggest challenges this year were higher prices for goods and food, wage increases, and more government regulations.
We're also seeing that some folks had a really great 2022 and 2023, and perhaps that's leveling off a little bit more in 24.
You can see that trend in the survey as well. Back in 2021, 70% of business owners saw more travelers than they expected. That number has gone down every year. Instead, in 2024, more than half of the owners said they saw fewer customers than they expected.
Overall, we have seen a downtick.
Jamie Olson is the CEO of the Centro Restaurant Group. She says a lot of restaurant owners in the Twin Cities are seeing fewer customers and higher costs of doing business.
Things have gotten really expensive. Minimum wage went up, so obviously that drives up prices for restaurants.
On the northeast side of the state, in the Brainerd Lakes area, business owners were more optimistic.
It's been down maybe a tiny little bit.
Nicole Heinen with the Brainerd Lakes Chamber of Commerce says many hotels and restaurants did see a slight drop in revenue this summer, but many are making it up with a better than average fall this year.
We just got done with Cross Lake Days in Cross Lake, and there was a huge turnout. So many people out there. They're already seeing a ton of people coming up here just to enjoy the leaves and the change of colors.
Business owners statewide also say it was easier this summer to find staff to fill their positions, and only 8% said they were cutting jobs this year. Explore Minnesota is also hopeful for the future, with the Twin Cities Metro seeing higher hotel occupancy this fall. And hopefully, that trend will continue this winter.
We're very excited to kind of just get back into those seasons and have people experience all four seasons of Minnesota.
Another factor here is that travelers may be settling back into a normal, new normal after the pandemic. The DNR is seeing a similar trend right now with state parks. This graph here shows how many daily permits were sold each year. This gray line here was 2021. You can see it's the highest. That's back when everything was closed and everyone had to spend their time outside. And you can see every year it's kind of trending back to this green line here. That's 2019, pre-pandemic. So we're kind of seeing that with state parks and trails as well, kind of that coming back down to normal after all of that pent-up excitement to get out and travel.
Right, the pendulum swing from nothing to let's go do everything to getting back to the middle.
And another thing I saw today was that with the two of the people that I interviewed, I asked the same question about the winter. One person says, we really want a mild winter here in the Twin Cities because people go out to the restaurants, but up north, they want a really snowy winter because they want people to be driving snowmobiles, snowshoeing and stuff like that. So what hurts one part of the state and one business might actually help another business across the other part of the state.